I am Arvind, working as a lecturer in Shraddha College and executive member in Nalgonda Economics Forum. Welcome to Nalgonda Economics Forum. So today in this video, I want to explain about what is the nature and scope of economics, right? So in the last previous classes, we had discussion about what is the definitions of economics and what are the major fundamental problems in an economy. That's what we had a discussion in the last previous class. So coming to today class, which I am going to explain nature and scope of economics. So generally, economics subject is the vast area. So the thing is that whatever the, if you focus economics, we need to be think about classical economist and modern economist. So what economists used to say that, so all the economic activities are major thing is that, so less effort, maximum satisfaction. So whatever the economic activities which we are doing with respect to less effort and maximum satisfaction, that is what all economics motive. And coming to the major economic contributions, whatever the major economic subject which studies about the things which are consumption, production, exchange, distribution and income, employment, planning and economic development. So these are the basic and traditional things which we need to be learned in this economic subject is that consumption. So what do you mean by consumption? Consumption is that to satisfy the goods and services, whatever we are receiving, whatever we are benefiting, that consumption of goods and services, that is what consumption. So all the production, whatever the exchange, distribution, all the basis of this consumption. And coming to the production, production means what are the factors, land, labor, capital, entrepreneur. There is the inverse relationship between inputs and output. What are the technical relationship between inputs and output is that production function, right? So production, which will be to based on consumption, based on demand, the production is there. At the same time, exchange, after the producing the goods and services, we need to be exchange the goods. Right. The meaning of exchange is that earlier ancient history or else earlier we used to be distribution, whatever the exchange of goods and services, we need to be one good to another good. There was a exchange of goods. That's what barter system we used to call. So later there was a money came to exist. When the money came to evolution, so that there was a very easy to exchange the goods and services. Right. So coming to the distribution next. Distribution is that whatever the factors of production, what are the contribution of factors of production, land, labor, capital, enterprise, there was a returns, what extent, what are the factors pricing has to be distributed. That is what distribution theory, which we will study in the economic subject. And coming to the income, income is the flow concept. So whatever the individual as well as simultaneously entire whole economy, national income. So individual, while participating in economic activity, they will get income. From that income, they will try to purchase goods and services. That's all about will be studied in the economics. And it is simultaneously will be studying entire economy. Entire economy, for example, studying the national income and calculating the national income methods. That's what all about income will be studied in the economics. And coming to the employment. Employment means that whatever the, if you demand for consumer goods and capital goods, all about depend on employment. So there is a demand for consumer goods and capital goods. So there is a employment. So employment is the major important concept in economics. So these are the basic concepts which we are learning here. So and coming to the economic planning and economic development. What is economic plan? To prepare economy in proper manner, to develop economy in the structural manner. So economic planning is the most important aspect. And development, economic development, what is, first of all, what do you mean by development? What do you mean by development? Growth. So growth is the, there is a continuous increment in the whatever the GDP, whatever real GDP or national income, whatever. So the percentage, the GDP percentage, the growth, the production percentage increment, which is called growth. And coming to the economic development, which means that entire all aspect, for example, at the same time, national income as well as development in the socio-economic structure of the country. So that's what all about will be studied in the planning and economic development. So these are the basic concepts which we need to study in economics subject. So coming to the economics, there will be whatever the problem and cause. Cause and effect also will be studied in the economics, right? So coming to the whatever the economics in the modern economy, if you look at the modern economics, there is a Ragnar Fish, economist Ragnar Fish, in 1933, he has divided two branches at two terms, which is microeconomics and macroeconomics, right? So what do you mean by microeconomics? Microeconomics is that study about individual firms, individual industries, right? So whatever the things which will be focused on individual, very small portion of economy, small portion of things which will be studied in the microeconomic perspective. And coming to macroeconomic perspective, we'll study about entire all economies, right? So coming to the, what is the microeconomics? What is the scope of microeconomics? We will look at here. See, here, microeconomics which will be studied major product pricing, factor pricing, and theory of economic welfare. See, what is a product pricing? What is the product? Generally, just now we had discussion. Product pricing means whatever the consumer, see here, demand for goods. In the economy, generally, in economy, if there is no demand, there is no production at all. So first of all, the consumer wanted to demand goods and services. When the consumer demand for goods and services, there is a possibility to production of goods and services. So first of all, productive pricing. So what extent people are demanding goods and services? What amount? So what quantity goods and services are needed? So that's what we will be studying in the demand, whatever the consumer behavior, what consumers are trying to produce, whatever consumption of goods and services, how consumer trying to be in market. So what kind of goods he wanted to consume? That's all about we'll study based on theory of demand. That's what law of demand, law of equimolality, law of diminishing molality, ordinality, cardinality. These are all concepts which will be studied in the theory of demand. And coming to the theory of production cost, we'll study about all the means, whatever the consumer, one side consumer point of view, we had studied in the theory of demand. That's what consumer theory of behavior. That's all about based on cardinal approach and ordinal approach. We will be studying in the next classes. So cardinal basis, we will be studying law of diminishing and law of equimolality. At the same time, ordinal basis, we will be study about indifference curve. Indifference curve, which will be mainly developed by the GRX and Allen, and law of diminishing and law of equi, which will be developed by Alfred Marx. That's all about we'll study in the next classes. So in the product pricing, mainly theory of demand and theory of production and cost. Theory of demand, we will study about consumer behavior, how the consumer behavior would be there in the market. That's what we'll study in the theory of demand. And coming to the theory of production cost, what is a theory? Means how the goods and services has to be produced by using the whatever the land, labor, capital, entrepreneur. These are the factors we will use to produce the goods and service. Means how much cost we need to. So we will be studying about the cost analysis, average cost, marginal cost, total cost. All about we'll study in this particular variable cost, implicit cost. All about we will be study and opportunity cost. Major important opportunity cost. So what do you mean by opportunity cost? Opportunity cost is that the best alternative choice. Generally in economic, there is a problem. What is the basic problem in economics? There is a scarcity. What is the scarcity? Scarcity means unlimited wants, limited resources. That is what we have a scarcity problem. So to solution that particular problem, whatever the scarcity problem, so we have a limited resource. So in that limited resource, we have the best optimum choice. Best optimum choice, whichever choice which is the best for that, we will choose that. So opportunity cost is that whatever you are choosing, best next alternative we will choose. So that is what opportunity cost we will choose, and we will try to produce the goods and services. Right? That's all about we'll be studying in the macroeconomics, product pricing, in that demand theory, at the same time theory of production and cost. Right? And coming to the next, factor pricing. So what are the factors which are incurred? What are the factors which are trying to produce the goods and services? That's all about household sector to business sector. We already studied in that last class. Household sector, what are the household sector? Society means people would be there in the household sector. So people try to participate in their economic activity in the business sector. So the land, labor, capital, entrepreneur, this will move on to the the income or whatever the factors will move to the industrial sector. So industrial sector will give return what after their return, whatever the things which here land will be get return rent and labor will get return wages and interest. Why participating economic activity as a capital means buildings, machineries and some sorts of tools which all will be participating in the production activity, right? So for that return will get here interest rate, and coming to the profit, by organizing, by initiating the all the factors, land, labor, capital, entrepreneur would be there. So entrepreneur will get return as a profit. That's what returns, that's what factor pricing which will be studied in the microeconomic perspective, right? And coming to the, that is all about theory of distribution. J.B. Clark theory of distribution will be studied in this chapter, right? And coming to the theory of economic welfare. Theory of economic means how goods can be managed, how can be efficient resource, how can we resource can be efficient in the consumer point of view and producer point of view. Producer point of view means whatever the resources are there in the country or the society, how can we utilize maximum with the less effort, how can we utilize? That's what opportunity cost will apply that. And coming to the consumer, less amount of income, how can he will satisfy maximum satisfaction? That's all about, that's efficiency will study in the Pareto optimality, at the same time welfare, all ACPGO. So there are the different efficiency criteria will be studied in the theory of economic welfare. So that's all about individual firms, individual units which will be studied in the microeconomic perspective. So majorly the Marshall, Alfred Marshall, principles of economics, he explained about all this particular consumption, production, exchange and distribution all about. So right, this is what will be studied in the microeconomics. So what are the importance by studying the microeconomics, what are the importance we will get here? So the major importance here to whatever the free market economy, to produce the goods and services, to expand the goods and services, that's all about microeconomics will be help us. At the same time, to frame the tax structure, right, to frame the government policies to better efficient allocation of resources, that's all about will help from microeconomics, right? And it helps to make international trade, to extend, how can we manage the exchange rate, how can determine the exchange rate, that's all about supply and demand, it's all about microeconomics only, right? How can we manage international, how can we do international trade with respect to exchange rates, it's all about supply based on supply and demand, right? That's all about will be helped from by the microeconomics only. So this is what all about means, whatever the analytical, whatever the things which will be decision making to help for better allocation of resources, to better decision towards the economy, microeconomics is the major and fundamental principle for all subjects, public finance, international trade, growth and development, and whatever the environmental economics, Indian economics, each and every aspect to microeconomics is the basic importance to all economic aspects with respect to different units, right? And coming to the macroeconomic perspective, if you look at the macroeconomic perspective, see what is macroeconomics, why the macroeconomics we need to study. My macroeconomics is generally in the 1929 to 30 academic financial year, there was a great depression in the USA. Why? Because there was a higher amount of income their pocket in the US, so people are trying to keep their money in the stock market. So it's all about sometime the people, the richer community, the big personalities like big industrialists, they try to get back their income from the stock market. So suddenly at a very short time the people are get back, very common people, each and every person has tried to get back their income, their whatever their stocks, their shares, their bond, they are getting back to their pocket. So what happened, entire stock market has collapsed, though the great depression has there in the 1929 to 1930. So in the mid year 1929 to 1930s, there was a great depression in the USA. So entire world economy, there was a problem in that time. So there was a great depression. That's what great depression means, the people are unable to access their minimum employment, minimum demand. People are unable to demand for goods and services. People are lost their jobs because already people are get back their all money. So people are not able to invest. The investors are not able to invest in money in the industries. So already supply is very low, very higher amount of supply is there. So people are not able to purchase the goods and services. So the supply is increasing, demand is decreasing. So that's what very great depression in the economy. So people are losing their employment opportunity. So people are unable to minimum basic needs at all that time. So that's what major problems in the economy. So that is the reason why the problem, which is Great Depression, tried to clear by the John Maynard Keynes in the 1936, the General Employment Interest and Money. He explained in his book all the macroeconomic perspective, how the Great Depression can be solved by the intervention of the government expenditure. How can government intervention, means government will be expenditure, because all private owners are get back their income, means private owners are ready to invest more, because already there is no demand for that goods and services. So there is no money in the market, there is no money in the society. How the people will invest, how people will consume their goods and services, how people purchase the goods and services. So there is not possible. So there is a lack of demand. So J.M. Keynes thought that investment more and more means government investment, means fiscal policy, fiscal intervention is the most important. So that is what J.M. Keynes given the definition in his book, how when the government investment more and more and the public, right, the pump priming which should be there in the economy. So what have a generally US economy all about? Capitalist economy. There is a free market, means only private owners would be there. So when the J.M. Keynes explained that the government intervention has to be there in the society, so that is the reason why there is aggregate demand. So aggregate supply and aggregate demand, when the demand increases, the supply will be, it should be equal. So that's what effective demand, so that economy will be move on better position. So that will be positive aspect. So the people income will be rises, the try to consume more and more, generally automatically the economy will be balanced, right? And coming to the how, what the things which will be include, what will study in the macroeconomic perspective. Let's look at here. Macroeconomics, theory of national income and employment. That is what? Theory of national income and an entire national income, means entire 29 states of in India. Entire state, we will be study how the each and every state, gross state domestic product, each and everything we will accumulate, we will get together and we will calculate, means we will, whatever the calculation methods which were expenditure method, these are three methods which were to calculate the national income. So it will be steady macroeconomic perspective, all three methods, whatever the income method, expenditure method, whatever the output method, these are all those things will be steady in the national income theory, right? Theory of national income and employment, how employment will be substituted, means by providing the government intervention, that's what employment will be clear, right? So at the same time, consumption and investment, in that employment only, consumption theory and investment theory, how the people, there will be autonomous investment, right? There will be APC and MPC, that's all about we'll study in the macroeconomic perspective. And investment, MEC, marginal efficiency of capital, rate of interest. So investment theory and whatever the consumption theory which will be studied in this particular macroeconomic perspective. And coming to the theory of general price level, right? Generally, if you look at the last 10 years back, the prices are very less. If compare whatever we are purchasing at right now, whatever the goods which we are purchasing right now, that almost it was increased a 10% or 20%. That's the reason behind that inflation. So why the inflation? If the inflation is very high, the people not able to purchase goods and services, means the price will be increases continually. So the problem, the inflation situation, the price managing, the controlling the price, it's all about macroeconomics, right? And coming to the economic growth, economic, how can we economic growth, means we can try to maintain, means we are looking at entire economy, all prospective at the same time, agriculture, industrial, manufacturing, whatever the employment, inflation, right, population, all aspect we were looking here, right? Not only single unit, we are looking at entire economy, India wise, at the same time world, right? We are looking entire economy on the earth, on the world, so that it is a possible to look at each and every aspect of economy. So there is a possibility to make economic growth, how, what kind of things we need to take, what kind of solutions we can give it. So that's what all about economic growth. It is helped by the macroeconomic aspect. And coming to the theory of macro distribution, means Here we had seen here prices, rent, wage, interest, profit. This is very individual, means very small prospect. If you look at the theory of macro distribution, means entire economy, how many goods and services are there, how many, what are the factors, returns, entire aspect too we will look at here. So macroeconomic distribution will be there here. And coming to the theory of business cycles, what do you mean by business cycles? Business cycles means that each and every economy, there is a fluctuations in economy, right? What are the fluctuation? There will be depression, again recovery, boom, recession. So there is a fluctuations, mean up and down economy. There will be unemployment sometime, there will be full employment, there will be no demand for goods. And so this is what economic will be imbalance. There is a fluctuation with respect to different stages, which are depression, recovery, boom, again recession, again depression. So this is what economy will be up and down. So that's what fluctuations will be happen in the each and every economy. To solve that problem, to give solution that business cycle, the macroeconomics will be clearly give solutions. And so what are the importance of this particular macroeconomics? Macroeconomics all about study in this particular, all those microeconomy will be study product pricing, factor pricing and welfare, theory of economic welfare. At the same time, macroeconomic will be study about the theory of national income and employment, and what are the general price level, what are each and every goods and services price level will be controlled and manage the inflation conditions. At the same time, economic growth, at the same time theory of macroeconomic distribution, and all about at the same time theory of business cycle. So this is what will be studied in the macroeconomics. So how this macroeconomics will be help us, right? So to make employment, to provide employment opportunities, how can we give employment? If there is an unemployment situation, so we will try to think on that. If there is an inflation, so how can we? See, we can try to give the solution. How can we reduce the inflation conditions? And there is a distribution of macroeconomic perspective, entire economy. So there is a budget in allocation here. So whatever the income which were there in national income, what is the budget? So allocation of budget, distribution of income, right? So it's all about will be macroeconomics is the major important aspect. And coming to theory of business cycle, that's all about just now we had. So Great Depression 1930. So that's what to give the solution, to give the clarification, to give the problem solution, all about which will be help with the macroeconomic aspect too. So let's look at what is the difference between this microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics and macroeconomics, these two terms is divided by two branches, which is Ragnar Fish in 1933. Micro means small. The micro word derived from the Greek, micro means small units, right? Micro means price theory, right? And microeconomics means that it will be study of individual firms and industries, right? So this is all about microeconomic aspect. And coming to the macroeconomic prospect, macroeconomics means macro means, this is also derived, the word derived from the macro, it is Greek word. And macro means large unit, entire economy, right? So macroeconomics, which is mainly updated or developed by the John Maynard Keynes 1930s, the general employment theory of interest and money, the general theory of interest and theory of money, right? The general employment, interest and money, that's what John Maynard Keynes has explained, entire macroeconomic perspective, right? So macroeconomic, which will be study about all about national income, poverty, unemployment, population, poverty, each and every aspect macro will be look at. So that's what the basic difference between microeconomics and macroeconomics, the scope of microeconomics and macroeconomics, right? So I hope you all understood today lesson. So please like, share, and don't forget to comment. Thank you. We will come to next session. What are the concepts which will be there at the public goods and private goods, that's all about will be studied in the next video. Okay, I hope you all understood. Please give a comment. Thank you.